your immediate circle of friends, your family, your parents, your again, everybody that you your immediately know, get after them when they make mistakes, so on and so forth in terms of pollution. Demand that your job or your where you work, your city, your state, ecologize, you know, they do it. In other words, take an active role and be the conscience to make people be better. Also, Jainism is well known for its great business sense and capital. Why not put money into cheap solar cells for the roof, for making new ways, you know, making electric cars, making things that, again, reduce greenhouse gases, which are causing the crisis in terms of our life. So anyway, I'm saying that you know, there's a lot of things we can really take heart in if you really commit ourselves to it. Last point here, last couple of points. Support politicians. All right, well, I only got a couple more points. 10 seconds. Take an activist role, march, write, attend editorials. Jainism is known as the extreme practice of nonviolence. Should also be known as the extreme protector of the planet. Environmentalism is inherent in Jainist thought. So why not be? So why should it also not be its destiny? Okay. The end.
I'm pleased now to call on Professor Kokila Shah. She's professor in Somaya Center for Studies in Jainism and adjunct professor in the University of Madras. Please.
Yes. So my topic is man and nature relationship, spiritual perspective. In the present scenario, man-nature relationship needs to be revisited as there is disturbance in ecosystems because of the activities of men. Jainism is science with religion. It is said that religion without science is blind. Jainism has a rich tradition of high level and spiritual thinking about nature and life. Non-violence, self-restraint and penance, they constitute religion. According to Jaina scriptures, it is said, Dhammo Mangala Mukkitam Ahinsa Sanyamotavo. So these three concepts I have focused on, non-violence, self-restraint and penance. Now, what is environment? The broader perspective of environment includes not only mankind, animals, birds, insects, and vegetation, but the entire planet Earth, mountains, oceans, lakes, rivers, forests, trees, plants, flowers, and incredible biodiversity. Environmental concerns, they are serious issues today, like global warming, climate change, ozone depletion, greenhouse effect, pollution, loss of spaces. These are globally dreaded environmental hazards. Philosophers, scientists, and environmentalists have expressed grave concerns as regards this. In this connection, Jaina declaration on nature is important. The declaration was presented to His Royal Highness Prince Philip, President of the Worldwide Fund for Nature International. This was to mark the formal entry of the Jaina faith into the network on conservation and religion. Here the hand signifies friendly reassurance and the ethical responsibility of every individual. The word ahimsa appears on the center, which is central concept of Jainism. At below the hand is written the sutra of ecology, parasparopagraho jivanam. All life is bound together by mutual support and interdependence. So non-violence, no doubt in Jainism, it is said, is the crux of wisdom, and it means harmlessness. So in Jainism, non-violence is not merely the supreme religion, but it is a deity, the protector of the whole universe, the existential imperative, and it should be applied to the six kinds of life forms. In Acharanga Sutra, it has been said, the principle of the doctrine of Sat Jivanikaya, the six kinds of life forms. So Jaina biology, the science of soul, it describes scientific classification of living beings. There are immobile beings like earth, water, fire, air, plants, etc. Mobile beings like animals, men, and there is presence of life in all of them, and it is validated by science today. What scientists today have discovered, Jainism has, in Jainism we find it long before. Now Jaina Acharyas have asserted this principle of equality of all souls on the basis of the principle of consciousness. So modern geologists also support this view, right to live for all creatures. So today when we are speaking of right, then right to live is one of the important rights. Animal rights occupy important place in Jainism. We find a home for birds, animals, etc. So Jainism emphasizes biocentrism. It is concern for all life form, which means concern for environment. It is not anthropocentric or human-centric view, but we have to learn to live with diversity. The view is about inherent value to non-human species. It implies preservation of biodiversity from micro to macro level. Every year, you know, there is a loss of species we find in the news. So this is to be prevented. One has to learn to live. One has to learn to live with diversity. One has to learn to the principle of coexistence. Hence, protection of wildlife, plants, forests, etc. Here we are reminded of the Jaina views, like Jaina view of the vices. Hunting is considered as one of the vices. So what it means is we have to prevent the loss of animals. Jainism says that for preservation of biodiversity, we have to move from egoism to ecocentrism. So violence against elements of nature is a sinful act. So Jainism preaches ethics. The ethical considerations are of great importance. Cultivation of spiritualism is significant. It says respect for life, nature, no consumerism. And here we find that carefulness, the concept of Jaina. Criterion is not to destroy. For that, spirituality is required. So the problem is how to apply, how to prevent environmental degradation. And for that, it is responsibility of every soul to know. We must have knowledge, and this knowledge must be converted into wisdom. For that, Jainism advocates different practices. The rites of Jainism like Samayika, Pratikramana, etc., which are not without significance. So we have to turn to yoga and meditation. Performance of spiritual practices implies ecological self. Right conduct makes the difference along with right reason. So there is emphasis on what is called state of equanimity, samayika, then pratikramana, to give up sinful acts. Environmental hazards can be prevented by ethics and spirituality. And Jainism can provide environmental ethics, which can be the basis of global ethics. There is prohibition of certain industries in Jainism, like and certain business practices, which deal with destruction of life. Jaina code of conduct is profoundly ecological. Practice of vows amounts to sustainable development. This value-based Jaina ethics and the vows, 12 vows of householders, are important from environmental point of view. Take for example one of the vows Anarthadanda Viramanavrata. It means abstaining from harmful activities, useful, harmful activities which serve no purpose. All these have significance from the point of view of ecology. So it is said that disciplinary vows, multiplicatory vows, all these vows are important. Right behavior will make the difference. One has to abandon passions like greed, attachment, etc. So how the preservation can be achieved? Certainly with human resolve. See, the environmental degradation is not due to science and technology, but it is due to human activities. So we have to make rational use of natural resources. It is a human consciousness which has to be changed from internal, from outside, that is external self, one has to turn to internal self. There should be minimum requirements, self-control, penance, etc. So art of living and spirituality is to be practiced, then this pessimistic scenario can be avoided. First, there should be knowledge and conduct, and one must know the different life forms, and then one must exert the practice of non-violence and compassion. This concept is unique in more than one ways, and it gives solution for sustainable development. To conclude, perhaps the unique tradition of respecting sacredness of life is the hope of mankind. Jaina religion is the pathway to welfare proposed by omniscience. In the end, let us say, the whole universe is blessed. Let whole universe be blessed, and let everyone be everywhere, be happy and blissful, because it is easy to conquer the world but difficult to conquer the soul. So from the point of view of spirituality, from the point of view of consciousness, we have to tackle this problem of environment. One is blessed who grasps the wisdom of the Jaina, and still more blessed is one who exerts accordingly, for it is the way, it is the application of this principle which is important. True victor is one who conquers oneself, and even celestial beings bow to him whose mind is engaged in such religion. Thank you. Thank you very much.
And I request now Venerable Dr. Sumit Thero, and before that I read two sentences, curriculum. He says, being Buddhist monk at present working with Mahabodhi Society of India and all India Bhikkhu Sangha in training in, of Indian monks. I'm trying to restore the coexisting Jain, Hindu, Buddhist site in Deogarh, Lalitpur, in association with Mr. Ravindra Divakar Jain. His title is Jain and Shraman Perspective of Ecological Balance and Environment Protection. Please.
हम थोड़ा हिंदी में भी बोलेंगे और कोशिश करेंगे इंग्लिश में भी बोलने का. बहुत सारी चीजें तो बता दी गई, तो हमको ऐसे लगा कि शायद हमारे बताने के लिए भी कुछ बचा है कि नहीं बचा है. तो जैन एंड श्रमण पर्सपेक्टिव की बात जब आती है तो दो ही ऐसे धर्म की बात आती है, जैन और बुद्धिज्म, जो श्रमण सिस्टम को फॉलो करते हैं. सो दे आर द कंसर्न विद द इकोलॉजिकल बैलेंस. सो सेम वे यू सी हाउ दिस द केम द मैन तीर्थंकर, देन द सेम वे द बुद्धिज्म आल्सो केम, द बिसाइड द गौतम दी बुद्धा 27 अदर बुद्धिस्ट द सीनियर बुद्धा दे केम एंड दैट बुद्धिम केम, देन सेम वे द जैनिज्म केम. यहाँ पर देखें आप, हेवनली बींग्स, देन द हेलिस, देन इस सिस्टम में भी आप ये जो देख रहे हैं पार्ट पांच रंग है, इसका ब्लू सिग्निफाई द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द लविंग काइंडनेस, देन द सेम वे द मिडिल पाथ, देन द अचीवमेंट विजडम, एंड जो इसके पांच पार्ट हैं और इसको हम कन्फाइन करते हैं ले पर्सन्स, मीन्स जो रोब नहीं पहनते हैं, देन दिस पार्ट इज पर्टिकुलरली कन्फाइंड अप टू द मॉन्क्स एंड नंस. The same way you see the Jain flag depicted the Paramitas, then you see the Arihants, then Siddhas, Acharyas, then Upadhyay, and Sadhu and Sadhvis. So these are concerned with the flags. This is the abstract, you can say. This is only the abstract. how that the Buddhism gone, there are many, many reasons. Maybe this some attack, maybe some famine, or maybe some other natural calamities. But the Theravada Buddhism, then Mahayana Buddhism, then Vajrayana Buddhism, whatever the yarn you can call, but the much of those, they gone from the land of India. And that is also confined up to the Uttar Pradesh or Bihar or whatever you call the Magadha region. The same way, the Jainism also, it also appeared in the state of Bihar or whatever you call it, Uttar Pradesh. And due to the natural calamities, they migrate to the other places. Then they go to the other places of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. So Karnataka or Tamil Nadu ki taraf natural calamities ki waraj chale gaye. Aur is tarah se jo Buddhism hai, or due to the nuns and monks, jo nuns and monks, jo different you see the part of the globe, jo physical system se dekhen aap, usko political system se na dekhen, then they spread other than you see the Africa, most of the you see the part of the world they have the monasteries. Now the Jainism also came, number of you see the organization and they are coming up. Then this is what does Jainism teach? Mahatma Gandhi also explained, and the number of time he you see the emphasized the same way the birth of the Buddha under the you see the forest. Then he get enlightenment under ficus religiosa, that is the people tree, and his life, the preaching of first you see the lesson in the Sarnath under the forest garden. Then same he took you see the Mahaparinibbana under the then come to the ahimsa. So, जैसे हमने पहले भी जिक्र किया आपको कि जब अहिंसा की बात आती है, जब हम ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा चीज़ों को कंज्यूम नहीं करते हैं और हम अपनी लिमिटेशन तक इन्वॉल्व रहते हैं, तो आपको इन्वायरमेंटल प्रोटेक्शन के लिए या इकोलॉजिकल बैलेंस के लिए यू आर मोर कॉन्सर्न. वेन एवर यू सी दी एक्सटेंड योर डिमांड, हमने देखा बहुत सारी जो कम्युनिटी हैं, बहुत सारे लोग हैं एक ही प्रकार की स्पीसीज को खाने के लिए बाध्य हैं. या मान लीजिए बहुत सारी बर्ड्स आपने भी देखा होगा, द पीपल्स आर कंज्यूमिंग ए पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ द बर्ड एंड दे आर किलिंग. देन नाउ ड्यू टू द कंजर्वेशन, नॉन कंजर्वेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, द स्पीसीज हैज गॉन. देर इज नो स्पीसीज ऑफ द बर्ड्स, देर आर सो मेनी ऑफ द लाइव स्टॉक ऑल्सो इन द सेम मैनर हैज गॉन. द सेम वे द 105 हैबिट्स दे हैव कल्टिवेटेड इन द मिलिंदपना ऑफ द त्रिपिटक. और त्रिपिटक में बताया गया कि भाई ये 105 जो चीज़ें हैं ये बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क को करना चाहिए, तो ऐसे नियम हमको विनय में बताए गए. दी मोर ऑर लेस सेम दी दी वाट एवर दी लॉ वाट एवर यू कॉल दी नियम और नियम इन दी जैनिज्म आल्सो. मोस्ट ऑफ दी सुत्तास द बुद्धा स्पेंड 19 ऑफ हिज वर्षावास इन जेतवन, दैट इज यू सी इन श्रावस्ती आउट ऑफ हिज 45. दिस इज द फोटोग्राफ ऑफ जेतवन. द सेम वे more or less Mahavir was a senior, I think about 40 years, so this was gone the life same way. Then come to the interdependence, the most of the things in the nature we are the interdependence. Then the ancient Jainism principle teach that the nature is bound together, as say if one does not care for nature, he does not care for the himself. In the same manner, number of species affiliated to the Buddhism, the Sakyaram of Isiniram, then come to the Cynodontactylus and Ciliarus, these are number of grasses, then Heterogon Emperata, and these, you see the grasses, they are coming as early after the degradation, and the grasses are only the, okay. So the same and not to waste. हमारा कहने का मतलब यही है कि आप अगर आप बचाएंगे नहीं तो उसमें आगे के लिए आप नहीं रह सकते, तो वेस्ट ना करें. और दूसरा ये है कि दी हॉस्पिटल और ह्यूमन बींग्स के लिए और एनिमल्स के लिए जो जैंस की बात आती है, वहाँ बुद्धिज्म में पर्टिकुलरली अशोका के पीरियड में ऐसे जो हॉस्पिटल्स उनको इस्टेब्लिश किया गया. और ये जब टेररिज्म की बात आती है, बहुत सारी ऐसी दिक्कत की बात आती है कि भाई इसके लिए क्या सॉल्यूशन निकाला जाए जिससे हमारी नेचर प्रोटेक्ट रहे, हमारी आगे की जनरेशन ठीक ठाक रहें, तो उसके लिए अल्टीमेटली लोगों ने ऐसा सोचा ये तो सॉल्यूशन जो मिलता है वो श्रवण सिस्टम में ही मिलता है. और श्रवण सिस्टम की जब बात आती है तो ये जो बात है वो जैन और बुद्धिज्म की तरफ ही आती है. और जो माइग्रेशन की जहाँ बात आई है तो बुद्धिस्ट पीपल पर्टिकुलरली दी मॉन्क्स दे माइग्रेटेड मॉन्क्स एंड नंस वेरी मच कंपेरेटिवली जेंट्स आल्सो माइग्रेटेड बट कंपेरेटिवली लेस सो दिस इज यू सी दी एक्ट द इंडस्ट्रियल एज हाउ टू अफेक्ट दी इन्वायरमेंट जो लोग बोलते हैं भाई हम तो विकास तो करते जाएंगे और बाद में तो ऐसे कंजर्व हो जाएगा तो विकास करते करते बहुत सारी स्पीसीज तो चली जाएंगी नंबर ऑफ स्पीसीज विल गोन यू कैन नॉट यू सी दी अगेन इमर्स तो इस तरह से ये थोड़ा सा पिरामिड का है जिसमें देखेंगे तो थोड़ा इसमें बहुत इसी ज़्यादा बोलने की जरूरत नहीं है वो सेक्स सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी में और कई चीज़ ऐसी होती हैं जो रोब पहनने की जरूरत नहीं है लेकिन बहुत सारे लोग ऐसा काम करके चले जाते हैं कि उनका नाम ये हमेशा के लिए चाहे वो बर्ड्स के साथ है या एनिमल के साथ है या इन्वायरमेंट के साथ में ऐसे जुड़ा रहता है ये पर्टिकुलरली ये जैन हॉस्पिटल जो दिल्ली में है उसका ये जिक्र है और हॉस्पिटल है तो बर्ड्स भी अपने आप आती है उसे पता है हमको यहाँ पर ये प्रोटेक्शन मिलेगा हमको यहाँ ट्रीटमेंट मिलेगा तो सेम वे जैसे आप लोग देखते हैं हमको हॉस्पिटल है तो ऐसे ट्रीटमेंट मिलेगा तो ऐसे हमको ये इस्टेब्लिश करना चाहिए ऐसा हम ये कहना चाहते हैं वट वी चांट इन द डिफरेंट सुत्ता इन द मॉर्निंग एज वेल एज इवनिंग एंड द नंबर ऑफ द 84,000 दे हैव एक्सप्लेन सो दिस इज यू सी दी बाई दी योर बेल आई एम फिनिशिंग सो थैंक यू वेरी मच
Now we just have time for maybe two questions from the audience. Please, and I'll ask you to respond, whoever.
Yeah, I have a question to you. Sir, in the context of environment and also in the context of non-violence, has Buddhism embraced vegetarianism or it hasn't?
As per the need. The Buddha emphasized for the human need, not for the human greed. That was the main answer.
My question is to Mr. Kim Skoog. He pointed out that ahimsa is only the principle by which environmental studies. He presented environmental studies. On the basis of non-violence, ahimsa. But I think bhogo bhog parimana vrat, seventh vrat, also to be included. He told that non-living thing, Jainism is not serious to non-living things. But by upabhog paribhog parimana vrat, non-living things are also in the center.